What is up, you guys? Happy New Year! It's Adanna. Welcome back to my channel. I just wanted to say thank you guys so much for joining me on this journey. I really wanted to start this new year off fresh, and one such thing is that I'm going to be doing videos every Sunday and Tuesday, so be sure to come back on Tuesday because I will be putting another video out for you guys, either answering your questions or something like lifestyle-y vlog style video. So come back so you can see exactly what that video is going to be. I'm also going to be incorporating some like giveaways and just kind of like more giving back to you all in a more monetary sense, I guess you can say, because you guys have been following me on this journey for like 3 years now, and it's been quite an amazing ride. And so I'm in a position where I can do that, so that's what I would like to do for you guys. So you have to follow me on Instagram and subscribe to this YouTube channel so you can know exactly when those giveaways are happening. But this video is going to be a question that was posed to you all, to me by one of you all. It's from MB. It said, did you feel like PA school adequately prepared you for your role and or your field, and pants as well? Is each program different in this sense? Do you feel a difference between you and other PA graduates from other programs? And how would you describe the competency that both clinical and didactic year provide for you now and that you're out of school? Lots to dig into. Let's get into it right now. Doing my dance, hey. I'm doing my dance. Don't mind me. I'm doing my dance. Hey. All right, so there is a lot in this one comment that you left me, MB. So I'm going to tackle like the first half of it, and then the second half will be tackled in my video on Tuesday, just because I think that there's a lot to unpack in this. But the first part that I'm gonna address is, did I feel like PA school adequately prepared me for my role and my field, and also the pants as well? And I mean, you guys, I know you've seen like my video from like, I guess almost 2 years ago now, when I initially like didn't pass my boards the first time around, and I came out and I told you guys why I felt I didn't do as well as I think I could have done, and then I passed it the second time around and I officially became a PA, yay! No, but honestly, I do feel like PA school prepared me adequately for the boards, definitely, because a lot of what we learn in PA school is really geared towards the boards. I feel like I didn't necessarily perform as well as I could have performed on the boards because I was just so nervous. I was so fearful of like, what if, right? You know, what if I'm the one that doesn't pass the boards? And I happened to be the one because I let my fear get the best of me. And, you know, moving forward from, you know, not passing the boards on the first time and then coming back around the next time and like doing significantly, like leaps and bounds better than I did the first time, I realized that like fear is literally the enemy of greatness, okay? You cannot be great if you're fearful to take those steps to be great. And that fear will cripple you so much so that you really just don't see past it. And I allowed that to happen to me. And so that's why I feel like I didn't perform well on my boards, but I definitely feel like PA school prepared me extremely well for the boards, because that is really what they're teaching you in PA school. How to pass your boards, how to answer these board type questions. Yes, we are getting like the medical based stuff, or the foundation of medicine and how it pertains to us as PAs and how we will practice. But ultimately it's really like, okay, what, how, like, let's get down to like how the boards will ask this question and then how you should answer this question. Now, the first part of your question was, did you feel like PA school adequately prepared me for my role and my field? Now, me specifically, I would probably say not really, because a lot of what PA school prepares you for is just like the general aspect of things, because we're trained as generalists. You know, typically when you get into like a specialty, you're trained like on the job in that particular field, in that specialty. They show you what they want you to do. They, you know, tell you how they want you to do something. And yes, you have the foundation. So yes, we have a foundation of like musculoskeletal and cardiovascular and OB and peds and orthopedics, which I guess is musculoskeletal, and, you know, GI. And we have this foundation of like what are the things, the common things, you know, common things being common. So what are the things that we're going to see generally in the field? Or what are we going to generally see in, you know, an urgent care or emergency medicine or family medicine? Because we're trained to see the general aspect of things. But when it comes to the specialty, not so much so. You just kind of touch on the basic common things, and then I guess it's expected that once you get in your field, you're gonna get that on the job training. And so for me, since I'm super specialized in trauma, and yes, I need, you know, like a basic knowledge of things like, you know, blood pressure. Like I'm looking at, okay, well, what's this person's blood pressure as they come in as a trauma? Is it high? If it's high, then I know that I can give them something like fentanyl or something else that's going to drop their blood pressure, but not significantly so, where I'm gonna now have to see, all right, do I need to give fluids to raise this BP? Like what, I get to play around with things like that. But I need to know those basic things, like if they're on BP medications, or, you know, if they're taking like a phosphodiesterase inhibitor or something like that. I don't know. But there are things that I have the basic general knowledge of. But for the most part, I'm going through like these ABCDEs. I'm going through these specific things. I'm very like pinpoint algorithm. And I didn't really learn that in PA school because it's super specialized. So once I got into my job, yes, I knew like common things being common, but when somebody comes in as a trauma and, you know, their face is like slashed up or they have a bunch of various different broken bones, I need to know, okay, let me assess them acutely initially. And then apart from that, what I'm going to do is call my, you know, ortho PA, you know, or call my plastics, you know, attending, or urology if they have like some type of bladder injury. But I have to be able to source these things out and know like, all right, well, I'm going to go to CT scan and get this. So I don't think that PA school prepared me for the specific things that you see in specialties, but I definitely feel like they prepared me for the general. So if I were to be like, I would say like a emergency medicine PA or an urgent care PA or family practice PA, I think I would be fine. You know, there wouldn't be such a harsh learning curve as there has been or as there is, because I'm still learning a lot currently in my current position as a trauma PA. But again, that's just because we're trained as generalists. And I mean, I like that because at the end of the day, again, if I wanted to go to another field, you know, you guys know that I'm very interested in OB. And if I want to get into OB at some point down the line, then hey, I have the opportunity to do so. I don't have to go back and get more certification or more training, you know, outside of what I already know, and go back to school to get that. I can just get it on the job. So hopefully that answered your first part of the question. I will definitely hit this second part of the question up, which talks about how did I feel like there was a difference between me and other PA graduates? And then also, what was the competency that both didactic and clinical year provided for me and my practice now? And so we're gonna talk about that in the next video. So if you are interested in hearing any of that information, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, like this video, and come back on Tuesday for that video, because I will be addressing those topics on that video. And please leave your comments in the comment section below, you guys. I answer your questions. I will do it either in the comment section or in video form. Thank you guys so much for watching. Happy New Year to you guys. I love you all. I wish you a great and prosperous New Year. And I will talk to you guys next time.